Greetings and salutations, Second Star Right, back with some more Raid Shadow Legends, and if we will look in our bastion today, or starting today, rather, you will see this little gentleman sitting next to our shards on the portal. What is he? He's a new fusion. It seems that Clarence decided that it's fusion time once again, and if you read the news, it says, "It's been a while since we've had a good old fusion. We have just the champion for you, Gurptic Mossbeard." I have two issues with this. One, the name Gurptic Mossbeard, that does not roll off the tongue in any kind of appealing way whatsoever. Gurptic. Gurptic Mossbeard. I'm not a huge fan. Also, they say it's been a while since we've had a gold fusion. It has been 12 days. So I think that Plarium's idea of a while and my idea of a while are two very different things. But regardless, it is fusion time again. 12 days after the Skull Lord Vargal graced us with his presence. So now we have Gurptic Mossbeard of the Ogryn Tribes, and is he any good? We shall see. Alright, so let's click on this dude here. Limited time fusion event, 2 weeks, 5 days, in an hour. He can be fused once. That's probably more than we need. Let's look at his skills, shall we? Okay, so this Ogryn Tribe legendary has a Biotic Staff as his A1. Attacks one enemy 2 times, places a 15% continuous heal buff for 1 turn on all allies who are under poison debuffs. Okay, good enough. You can book that 3 times for damage. Okay, his A2, Druidic Boon, removes all debuffs from an ally, then heals them by 30% of their max hit points, and places a shield buff on the target equal to 20% of their max hit points for 2 turns. So it's basically 50%, I guess, of their total hit points for 2 turns. And this is on a native 3-turn cooldown that looks like it can get down to 2 turns. So that's kind of cool. That's he's doing this this Druidic Boon every 2 turns that lasts for 2 turns. That's pretty awesome. That's not a bad skill whatsoever. All right, his A3 is tricky. This is an odd one. Cloud of Spores places 3 poison debuffs on all allies for 3 turns. These debuffs cannot be resisted or blocked. Also has an 80% chance of placing a block buffs debuff on all enemies for 2 turns. Okay, so you can block buffs, but you get 3 poison debuffs placed on you. Okay, and there is a benefit to that, however, where your symbiotes, venom problem again, where the Jenny Slate said symbiote really weird. Symbiote. Anyway, allies under poison debuffs inflict 7.5% more damage for each poison debuff on them, stacking up to a maximum of 30%. Symbiotes? 30%. This damage increase applies to all of their skills. Also increases each ally's resistance by 15 for each poison debuff on them. Okay, so there's good things come about from you being cloaked in clouds of poison. All right, so you get 7.5% more damage for each poison debuff. So 7.5%. Percent 3 times. So that's a really good damage boost. He also has an aura. What does the aura do? Resist in all battles by 50. Okay, that's kind of cool. All battle resist. That's a rare aura. Okay, so all right. So I guess that what would happen if he had like Taurus here or who else poisons them? Occult Brawler. I can see some really interesting things happening with this. You know what? Let's put a Cult Brawler, and you know who damages him, who puts poison on himself. We will put Taurus in there, and we can have like a sadomasochism, a self-flagellation team. That would be a lot of fun. So Gurptic could be leading them all. They could all be hurting themselves. And you know what? We'll put Abbess in there too, because she puts herself to sleep. You know, maybe she can torture yourself with nightmares or something. So yeah, I would totally look forward to building a sadomasochism team with Gurptic as the leader. Okay, that's my primary goal for getting this guy, is just to do that. Okay, so he's a fusion, so what does it take to fuse Gurptic? Ugh, what a horrible name. Okay, so we have the Fang Cleric. The Fang Cleric I'm not a huge fan of. Alright, we'll go over him real quick, what he does. He's a reviver. Attacks an enemy, 75% chance of transferring 1 random debuff from this champion to the target, but it takes 6 books and an A1. It just does not seem very interesting to me. Heals an ally by 20% of this champion's max hit points. This champion, so that's cool. So good healer, so you can always, you know, build him up with hit points and get some good heals out. Also fills the target's turn meter by 30% if they are fully healed by the skill. Places a veil on the target for one turn if they're not fully healed. Okay, so if you're fully healed, here's, you know, turn meter, get back in the battle. If you're not healed, go hide in under this bush, sit this one out for a turn and come back later. Okay, I can get that. Return to the ranks, revives a dead ally with 30% hit points, then fills their turn meter by 30%, also places an unkillable buff on the target for one turn, and a 15% continuous heal buff for two turns. So it is a really good revive. It's 6-turn cooldown, you get down to 4 turns. It's not a bad revive. And for a newer champion, he doesn't require a heap of books like a lot of them do. Well, I don't know. Maybe that's not true. 6, 10, 11, 12. Okay, so standard amount of books. And he has speed in all battles by 15%, which is not a bad all-battle speed boost. He's fine, right? I would not lose sleep if I had to sacrifice a Fang Cleric to get a legendary. Alright, here we have the Catacomb Counselor as the next fusion. He just kind of looks like someone left Zealota face down in a puddle for a while. Kind of gross, but let's see what he does. Okay, Catacomb Counselor, 50% chance of placing a 25% increased attack buff on this champion for two turns, then attacks one enemy. I like it when they do the increased attack and then attack, and kind of you get more bang for your buck. That's not a bad A1. Ghoulish Feeding is his A2, attacks an enemy 3 times, heals a champion by 20% of the damage inflicted. Okay, so, cool. Not a bad, I'm gonna heal on A2. It's not my favorite use of an A2, but what are you gonna do? Army of Death teams up with 3 random allies to attack a single enemy. The allies during the attack will use their default skills. Well, see, that's cool. Ally attack is awesome. This is 3 random allies, so it looks like more arena if you want to get everyone involved in the action. It's on a 5-turn cooldown that you can get down to 4 turns. That's cool. I love ally attack. I loved Hyria when I first started. She was one of my go-to champions. I graduated to Longbeard. Longbeard is all ally attack with up to 5 champions. So, I guess 4, so total of 5. Ally attack is a great skill, so if you don't have anyone with ally attack or you want to experiment with it, I highly suggest doing so. It's a fantastic skill. So, not a bad champion. I'm not too thrilled with his A2. His A1 looks strong if you don't have another attack buff. And of course, the A3 is very good. So, moving on. Seneschal. I like that name. That's a cool name. What does he do, though? Banner Lord. And he attacks an enemy, 30% chance of placing a leech for 2 turns. Leech has been buffed. Leech is now good. Based on defense and attack, which is an interesting twist. 4 books to get it fully booked with an extra 10% chance of landing up to 30%, up to 40%, and 40% still not great, but what are you going to do? A2 places a perfect veil, misdirect, places a perfect veil buff and a 50% continuous heal buff on an ally for 2 turns. That's kind of unimpressive. Okay, and then his A3 places a counterattack buff on this champion for 2 turns, has a 50% chance of placing a provoke debuff on all enemies for 1 turn. This is an awesome A3. The counterattack provoke combination is a classic. It's fantastic. 6 books, though, to get it down to 4 turns and increase the chance up to 100%. You know, it might be worth it. That's actually a really cool skill. I don't know if it's worth bringing an entire champion, wasting an entire slot just for that skill, but maybe it is. I mean, that is really powerful. Counterattack and provoke is pretty sweet, I gotta say. And he's defense-based champion, so he can soak up that damage. You know, that's not bad. Not a bad A3. Kind of a mediocre champion, but the A3 is class. And then, I love Umbral Enchantress. Let me rephrase that. I hate Umbral Enchantress because I don't have one. And whenever I see her in an arena, I just kind of want to, let's say I deprioritize those teams. Because I just don't want to deal. I don't want to deal with the hassle that she brings because, well, let's just get into her skills. First off, let's not get into her skills. She's designed really cool. I love that she doesn't wipe her mouth after she eats, right? It's very Mediterranean, right? Very like a passionate Greek or Italian. You know, you really enjoy your food, and I appreciate that about you, Umbral Enchantress. All right, let's go into her A1. Attacks an enemy. Damage increases as current hit points decreases. That's a skill I like. Hard to utilize effectively, but I do like it. I like the gear too that does it. Okay, attacks all enemies, has an 80% chance of placing a block buff's debuff for 3 turns. Yeah, that's again why I don't like her in arena. It's you know, I depend on my buffage. You know, I have a counterattack team. I need that going on, and she puts the kibosh on that, and it irritates me. And then Undying Evil is an amazing skill. Attacks all enemies, has an 80% chance of placing a provoke debuff for 2 turns, places an unkillable buff on this champion for 2 turns, places a block cooldown skills debuff on this champion for 5 turns, so there's the downside. Block cooldown skills cannot be resisted or blocked and can't be removed. Of course, that's the downside of doing the awesome other stuff on your A3. The unkillable and the provoke is just like, come on. Come on. And then plus, it meshes in with her A1. This is a really cool, nicely designed champion. Super irritating to face in arena, and I try to avoid her as much as possible. I don't have one, but I will. I actually, if I can only fuse one, then I might skip the legendary for Umbral Enchantress. You know, it's something I just might do because I do like that champion a lot. And Gerptic has a horrible name, and maybe I'm going to be biased just for those reasons alone. Okay, so and look at him. Doesn't he look like a young, skinny Gul'dan, right? Pre, you know, betrayal at Tomb of Sardras, right? World of Warcraft. Who's with me? Anyone else play WoW? Right? Yeah. So you know what I'm talking about. He kind of has that look about him. You know, his Kil'jaeden somewhere behind his shoulder, or maybe imprinted on his back. Yep. There we go. So anyway. I don't know. Guys, what do you think about Gerptic Mossbeard? I don't know. I don't know. I think that he brings an interesting and unique skill set, and it can be powerful, I'm sure, once you find out the right ways to manipulate it. The theme deck of having a sadomasochism team, I kind of dig also. That would be fun. Practically speaking, I just don't know. This is definitely a champion that I have to see in action before I make any decisions about whether this is someone that you should pursue or not. He does seem like he'd be not the easiest to use. You have to require like a lot of setups, make sure all your timings are right. I don't think he's someone you'd be able to slot in right away and just go to town. I think you really have to think through a team composition for this guy. But that's what we're here for, right? That's all stuff that I enjoy doing. So let me know your thoughts. Are you going to fuse? Are you just going to get the rares? The epics? What are you going to do? Let me know. I'd like to hear about it in the comments, and we have a little back and forth discussion about Gerptic Mossbeard. And maybe we'll just avoid using his first name and just stick with the Mossbeard. All right? Kind of like Tyrant Ixlimer, Ixlimor, whatever. It's just Tyrant. This guy's now just Mossbeard. I did the Mossbeard. Okay, guys, thank you very much. Comment down below, give me a like if you enjoy what you're seeing. Please subscribe if you want to see more, and I will see you guys in the next video, whenever that may be. All right, take care. Cheers.